Hey guys, it's your boy Kurt Perez, and welcome back to my FIFA 17 Liverpool career mode where I last left off. I picked up a win in the Capital One Cup over Wigan, and I defeated Spurs in the league. As you can see, I have enough of the team that could come the end of the season be one of the teams that's up there in terms of top four and challenging me. All the way for the title at Manchester City. Last season I beat Manchester City 4 times, beating them in the final of both the FA Cup and the Capital One Cup, as well as the 2 times in the league. So, yeah, this would be for 5 consecutive wins against Manchester City. In the 5 games against them. So. This is the Etihad.
And other clubs that has really made it.
He was going over Daniel Sturridge's form. Currently, he is top goal scorer, but only 1 goal ahead of Sadio Mane, who has 5. Daniel Sturridge has 6. He goes. Start of this game. We'll see where form takes his Philippe Coutinho.
Lloris Karius.
Alaba.
Alaba starts with the
good lovely transition there. You can work into space and Sturridge. Holy shit, left that for Mane. That's actually a slow storage, and I was trying to. I think Mane would have actually scored.
Oh, it could be dangerous.
Sturridge keeps the ball. Oh, and Brayley. Can he find Mane? No, and I fucked it up.
Be a throw. Otamendi. Fernando.
Great challenge. Daniel Sturridge! Good save by hey Joe Hart. Yeah. Don't need to be told that didn't cross the line.
It's good to have the replay because that helps us if it's tighter, but that wasn't one of the tighter issues.
No, I think we all knew it wasn't over, although one or two
dude.
Forwards were appealing with arms up.
Oh. And he gets past him. Coutinho works the space and scores his first goal of the season. And wouldn't you have guessed it? It's against Manchester City. They just can't. They're just sick of the sight of him.
Well, it is a good performance, this. They've got a goal to show for it. They're really giving themselves...
See, it works. Into a shooting position. Otamendi didn't do his job properly. If Fernandinho didn't fucking help, because he fucking stood there instead. Probably, he could have easily taken the ball off of Coutinho, but nope, just decided, yeah, I'll stand here. That's better, right? Fair enough. And 1-0 it is.
Attacking well here. It's the goalkeeper.
In fact, it took 4 Premier League games for Coutinho to score his first goal of the season. It is interesting. He doesn't seem to be scoring as maybe. Is this formation? I mean, he's still playing fantastic. You don't get me wrong, it's just... I thought he'd be chipping in with a lot more goals because he didn't score that many last season. Got a good few assists. But, as many as... He probably got the least of the 4 attacking players. And that's... I'm saying that as if he got less than Mane and Sturridge, because they got, both got, I think, 15 or something like that. And Coutinho got like 11. So, he didn't have his best season last season, despite the fact that he was constantly playing good. So, interesting. What else is interesting? He's probably the most improved rating wide player for of the two season or season and a bit. This season's only just started. But the fact that he's 88, he's starting at an 85. Is a tells you all you need to know about his former Sergio Aguero being the prick that he is, scored his first goal I've been saved this season. And my strikers went into each other. Brilliant. No, don't lose the head. That's exactly what will get me into a bad situation. Let's just calmly get a goal, get back in the lead, Sadio Mane. Of course. Non-issue. When that, yes. Chen, show some goddamn strength for fuck's sake. Don't just stand there and let the ball all be taken from you. Of course, Manchester United are currently not winning. Because I'm dropping points, they're going to drop points as well. So I can't take full advantage of it. Exactly. If they could, that's exactly how they would plan it. If they could plan it.
To get their noses in front from the corner. And now he's looking for... And now the shot!
Oh, just over the bar. How does that not go in, Daniel? Maybe I should have passed it. I mean, oh, it's inches over the crossbar. Yes, Daniel Sturridge wins his, the ball. Mane will put it in. Yes.
Mane is the main man for his side.
And Sturridge and Mane are level again. You know. I think this season's Premier League top goal scorer race is going to be a lot closer than last year's one. Would it have been this close if Sturridge just started from the off? Perhaps. We'll never know.
Nicolas Otamendi. Definitely a throw in there. Good anticipation by the opposing player there.
We can speculate.
Substitute for Manchester City.
Oh no. Get that shithead out of here. Good save, Karius.
Manchester City have a corner.
Oh, Mane has a clean through. Oh, one goal. Oh, yes, Mane. Oh, I overran it. Shit.
Well, as we know, you have.
I was trying to get away from the defender to have a clear shot, but because he was trying to pull me back, and I overran it. Fucking hell, man.
Silva, nice return pass.
Yes. Just to redeem myself. No, it's over a hit. So I overran it straight away after I fucking over hit the chance of a redeeming pass. win that Daniel. Preferably don't hit it to Aguero, you dumb shit. I'm getting angry now.
Good defending.
Get the fuck out. Good job, dude. Sturridge. He's up again. Penalty! Penalty! Yes, thank you. Oh. Fernando again. He made a mistake for the Coutinho goal. And now he has conceded the penalty. I think I accidentally said it was Fernandinho.
Surprise from the crowd.
Oh, hurry up. David Alaba. Makes it 3-1. Second goal of the season. In for the Austrian left back. Get in.
Took that coolly.
Tucked it home very nicely. That's giving me some breathing room in terms of the scoreline. But I want to get another goal hole before I make my substitutions.
Played down the wing, keeping the wide attack going.
Coutinho. Oh. No, he didn't get it far. What? Hey, it's come back to Coutinho. Chan. Dude! Off the bar! And here comes the header.
Promising build up until that challenge.
Dude had a stunning opportunity to make it 4-1 there. This might be 4-1. Fucking stones like a prick! Clearly, he held me off. Glad the referee didn't see it that way. Hey, thanks, referee. Thanks. That really fucking helped. You cunt. This is purely to get them extra games because my rating is going down. Despite the fact that I'm winning. And I think it's to do with the fact that they're not on course to have played 50% of the games. Are you fucking kidding me? Are you fucking kidding me? Did that seriously just fucking happen? I rolled it to hit him. Oh my god. Sturridge, thank you. This game is over. Thank you, Daniel Sturridge, for wrapping it up. He goes back to the top goal scorer. First of all, after Manny's earlier goal.
Well, it's just a footnote to the match, really. It confirms the win.
Yeah, I think the goal
could have passed it to Mane to be sweaty, but I trusted Daniel Sturridge to stick it in the back of the net and kill this game dead.
4-1 is the scoreline.
Players are coming on for literally the last few moments of the game. They didn't, none of them got a fucking touch of the ball. Oh. So technically, they put. Yes! Get in, West Ham! Beautiful. Oh, up the fucking hammers in that situation. Yes!
Manchester City 1, Liverpool 4, Middlesbrough 1, Crystal Palace 1.
Ah, that's an interesting. That is a. Quite an interesting group. Milan, Galatasaray. And Celtic. Brendan Rodgers is Celtic. Oh, I'm gonna fucking enjoy this season just as much as I enjoyed the first season. Yes! Celtic. I kinda wish they were first up so I could really just destroy this shit. But Galatasaray insists, well, the game insists on playing Galatasaray first. Galatasaray, I don't think they have any say in it whatsoever. Otherwise, they would not want to play me. Not in the form I'm in. Sis? Oh, crap! Origi wanted to play, I completely forgot.
with 3 points.
Sorry, Divock, you're playing in this game though. Oh, I guarantee it.
Hull City with 3 points.
Hull at the weekend. Make me decent. Check you. Another one who could be pretty good. It's weird that I'm getting Turkish players, just considering who my next game is. The Turkey. Well, one of the Turkish best teams in Turkey. Some people would say maybe the best. I guess that's arguable. I mean, there's also Beşiktaş and Fenerbahçe got in the end. Some people would say Galatasaray the best. Wait, whoa. Back it up. Almost winning this with my first team. But, it just occurred to me, I didn't switch it around. Which would be handy. I'm not gonna start. Probably should start Moya, but I'm not. I'm gonna start more. Let's also play these two. Where is Lopez? I wish he was a center back. Yo, he is not. He should not be a goddamn, thing. He shouldn't be a, he shouldn't be a left back. He doesn't have the pace for it. He's much better there. Especially because he's 6'6", so he can deal with it, with balls coming into the box from the corners. Anyone else I want to give a game to? No, I might bring on Shea Ojale here in the game. LeBlanc is actually going to start this. He could also be a player we get to a few appearances. I actually got an offer for Mensah near the end of the transfer window for Manchester City. Which was interesting, to say the very least. I rejected it purely because, well, it would have made him the most hated player in fiction. Oh wow, I'm not the only Premier League team playing hosting Turkish opposition. Chelsea are against Fenerbahçe. Oh, they're at the top. Dirt. Open your eyes, Corey, for fuck's sake. No, it's me. Shouldn't there be a few more games on? Or am I just... I'm imagining that. I don't know why I think there should be more games on. Not my problem.
Here we are, Alan, off and running. We love this competition, the Champions Cup. It's the group stage.
Here we go, Galatasaray.
A fantastic journey if you put it together, if you do everything right. Big game. This is the Liverpool.
I've played Galatasaray a competitive match ages.
Yeah, how it always used to be.
Played them a few times in like pre-season tournaments, but
put them in front.
That's about it. Interesting to see how I do.
Throwing coming up.
Last time I did a career mode in Turkey was with Galatasaray. I won the club with 3-something points to Fenerbahçe, if I remember correctly. This was before Beşiktaş became much better.
It's yet
early yellow card for player there. Carroll. It's almost like Carroll. Carroll. Recognizable players, I guess, for guys as a player, like Wesley Snyder and Lucas Podolski. I've considered possibly using Podolski or Snyder for career modes in the past. I'm still considering whether I should use Podolski at some point this season. Not in this career mode, I'm talking about in a secondary career mode. Because, he's a decent option.
Again, by the replay of the goal.
Because Feyer scored the first goal, first Champions League goal of from me on FIFA 17. This is actually the first time I've been in it. Of course, I couldn't be in it with the Rwanda Red Diamonds, and Leo are in the Europa League.
Attacking now. Well, they've been thwarted here.
Trying to get past the player and he ran straight into him. Fucking hell, pay attention, Texas. Alexander Arnold.
Corner to come now. He's tackled the ball behind, really.
And I realize his first name is Trent, but I don't. For some reason, I keep calling him Tex.
Made sure the ball is stuck at his foot. Bruma. Attacking well here. Out wide, they were in a good position until that defender acted very promptly and decisively. Got the tackle in.
Oh, that is a foul! I guess the referee's letting play go on because I have the ball.
He's coming forward with some.
Yeah, it's Henry on the right. What the hell? More! Ah, oh, could have been the second goal. LeBlanc! Oh, imagine what a goal that was, man.
I'm sure he would have thought that was going to bulge in the back of the net. Not quite, though.
I think that's the first time I've seen LeBlanc up close. I didn't know he had funky orange hair.
Bruma,
he's going to be dangerous with that pace. Good defensive work from Calabria, though, to get back to prevent any danger. Well, kind of, yeah. Gotten the ball away now. Alexander-Arnold, going to look for Origi. Not the best pass, as I've ever hit. Yes. Ooh. Oh, that bad foul if I connected with that slide. I didn't mean to. I don't know why I went for the slide. Origi! Aim it at goal! I don't know why he. It almost looked like he was crossing it, but I pressed circle to shoot. But it looks like he was rolling across for more to tap in, but I don't know what the fuck. That was bullshit. I don't know why that happened. I really don't. I can't explain it. Come on.
It's the goalkeeper's ball.
Then when I try to pass it, it passes it to the fucking goalkeeper. Brilliant. Do I have to attempt to shoot pass properly? Because when I tried to shoot to make it 2-0, when I wanted to shoot to make it 2-0, you passed it as if I was trying to sweat it to make it 2-0. Make up your mind what you want to do, game. I'm not happy. You at the moment? I'm happy with the The scoreline is fantastic. 1-0. You. Could be better, but we just saw Celtic and Milan are drawing. So, oh my god. Oh my god. Play in the direction you are facing, Origi. Don't turn to attempt the pass to the player I am not telling you to pass it to. Game thinks it knows more than me. See? Who scored that goal, Game? I did. That was a fucking rocket. Fenta. Fusa. Fenta. I can't pronounce this dude's name properly. Keep calling him all sorts of random shit. But that is a spectacular goal. And it is 2-0. Cool. Which is giving me a control over for the group stage in this early in the first games if the results stay as they are, and well, if this stays as it is or I make it better and Celtic and Milan do go to a draw. So instantly give me a 2-point gap. Okay, you can see some of the crazy transfers that happened on deadline day. Yes, Griezmann went to Manchester United and also went to Barcelona. Do not tell Arsenal that that might happen in real life, or they might go fucking off the hinges. Because Ozil's far and away their best player. He was our best player last season. He has improved this season. Which tells you a lot about him. Yo, Bruma is causing me all sorts of problems with the right back here. Against Calabria. Calabria is not exactly slow. Oh, but Bruma's pace is just fucking batshit crazy. He's another player I would say no to in a possibly signing a secondary career mode at some point.
To nudge you in the direction of what's coming up on EA Sports for you, our coverage of the Premier League fixture for Liverpool, they'll be hosting Hull City.
What was that? Was that your best attempt, Trent? Really? Was it? I really doubt it was. I really hope it wasn't. Make some changes. Get some players on. Get Shayojo, Moya, and Alan on.
Freshening it up, Liverpool, with the substitute now.
Give me easy dealt with. I sat down the pitch. Wouldn't matter. I went too far ahead.
We don't see that so often.
Fayor, just before he goes off for Ojo's arrival. Okay, set up a goal! No, he wins the corner though. Forcing Carroll to concede the corner. The two goal scorers are going off, actually, Mensa and Fayor, as well as Moore. Oh, freaking! That was actually Moya. Moya almost. If he made any kind of contact with that, he might have scored with his first touch of the game. Alan. Oh. I wonder, is it pronounced Alan or is it Alan?
Good support as they build this attack.
Oh, Riggy, how did you miss that? Oh, D-Rock, why? Wait, is he offside? No, he's not in offside. He sliced it. That's why he missed it. He completely sliced the shot. If he makes any kind of proper contact, he buries that person. Muslera for 3-0 and wraps up the game. Well, the game is probably wrapped up. There's 10 minutes to go. And Galatasaray, except for Bruma's runs, not really caused too much issue. Moya!
Corner now for Liverpool.
Hello. Change to the player I am telling you to change to. Game. Hell. I really thought they would patch that, but I guess I was expecting too much. This is the game talking about here. Moya! Oh, Carroll again! Fuck off, man.
The cross comes in now.
Ojo! Would you believe it? His Shea Ojo comes off the... And that might be his first touch of the game, is it? No, I think he's already been on the ball. Oh, but... It's a good goal from one wide midfielder to the other. And a good header from... who shouldn't really be winning headers. He's like 5'9", 5'8", and he wins the header pretty much unchallenged. Is it? He's not a game where you put his Nathan Drake.
Well, they've widened the margin now. 3-0 they lead.
Yeah, not bad. That is a good, convincing, and great start to the group stage. Now it doesn't even matter. Milan or Celtic could have won the other game, and I'm probably going to be top. Unless one of them has scored 4 goals, which, I mean, it's not impossible, but I would be really surprised. Although, maybe Ibaka is in form. You'd expect Celtic to be the whipping boys of this group. They almost always are. They're terrible in the Champions League. I don't know why people have high expectations of them. I don't know. Well, I mean, that they were once good in Europe? Not anymore. Celtic keeps just selling all their best players. Because how are they supposed to get anywhere? 2-2 finished. So, it did finish with 4 goals, technically, but... Near team scored all 4, so on top of the group.
Everton 1.
Way! And we have a new team in second place, Arsenal. Oh, that would be thanks to West Ham United. Yeah, no doubt. Oh, that's hilarious. In the next episode, but I have a league match against Hull, and I think I saw a game against Swindon. Yep, Swindon. Oh, look, coming up, the first game against one of the promoted teams, Brighton and Celtic, will be in the game after in the episode after that. But yeah. And thanks for watching. Don't forget, smash the like button if you did, subscribe if you're new. Until next time, I hope you all have a very nice day. Peace.